Your contract is due.
Oh yeah, I guess we're like never casting button.
Stand back.
Huh. Interesting.
Doing.
Learn their fears.
That seemed balanced to me.
You're doing?
Yeah, probably.
Winged justice.
No, I didn't. Calculated.
My favorite part.
Don't kill my guy. Kill both. Great. Love planning against freaking Argenport. Oh, Natalia. I love it. Favorite. So I'm gonna play this.
Choose a
man. They're gonna like know thy enemy. And it's actually not the end of the world. And I make more guys. There's the boys. Rank 69. The only time I get to enjoy this. Well,
end this.
Oh, they had a better answer. Frickin' Svetya. Oh, I could be playing Svetya. Unironically, actually. Well, she's a little expensive. I'd have to put some ref effort in the ramp into her. And at that point, it's like playing your 6 drop to buff your 4 drops, kind of meh. This is a witching hour deck. Like, for real. Get hives, you get high fives in the face with a grenadine.
My favorite part.
Hiya! Our curve ends at 5. And pull actually buffs. Because we're using pull to get back a rock. And there's a non-zero amount of time where we give him double damage. Like, not a lot of the time, but like I said, a non-zero amount of time, which is enough for me.
Never stop, never break.
Touch of shadow.
Halt!
Yeah, I like the idea of button, but if we're playing button, we're definitely not playing Kanfa anymore. I could probably still try and pull off Kazu. I hate everything about this card.
Looks like we're both getting shaped.
Just everything. Not really a part of that card I like. All of it can just go away. What am I going for here?
Your contract is due.
Can I pull in a nightmare? It's gonna be online. And Acantha's actually not the worst thing I can grab.
Our wings and will are unbreakable.
I was hoping I'd be able to kill that.
Face judgment.
I guess if I resign myself to not having double damage, I can kill it. Next turn.
What do you think you're doing?
It was in the deck, in the Xenan version at least.
A forest of blades. You come back here.
Suffer.
Oh, they left. Solo Makkar's Quiver ain't doing it. I guess this is keepable because of Sylph. But only if we draw power, like, in the next few turns. Hey, I'm a boss. Against this deck? Yeah. Oh, this might be clear the way. See, this is the one thing I like about the Xenan version. Okay, this is Combrei instead.
We can find a new use.
Can play. If they equivocate, or if they equalize us, our attachments are the only thing we can play and retain value. Now we get a Tazbu, though. And Syl actually puts a lot of fantastic pressure on this guy, or John. Because now, if they equalize us, we get a bunch of 1-1s, and they'll actually be real threats. Fine. this deck again. Well, we know what to do. Oh wait, this is something else. Is this Shadowless Rat Cage? Guess if I was my opponent, I'd take Sill. If I was playing Rat Cage. Well, I could see a world where you take the market instead.
What do you think you're doing?
Oh, clear the way combo? Right. I don't know why I didn't put that together. Fire this because it buffs my guys actually more than not doing it. They're probably blocking everything regardless.
You come back here. You come back here. A world of options. A world of options.
Now I'm feeling so fly, like a G6, like a G6, like a G6. Now I'm feeling so fly, like a G6, like a G6, like a G6.
You come back here.